you gave a Neanderthal a haircut, some soap and modern clothes, it wouldn't necessarily look that out of place in the 21st century. Key differences in their anatomy from that of a modern human would be shorter limbs, a broader chest, and a large nose. Humans are currently quite varied in our modern environment, but these Neanderthal adaptations, however, would have been key for their survival in a cold environment. For a long time, scientists and cartoonists alike would describe Neanderthals as being stupid and lesser when compared to the modern human. This fits with the same subconscious attitudes from the March of Progress diagram, that modern man is the superior species, the apex of evolution. Discovered in Germany's Neander Valley in 1856, before Darwin published his theory of evolution, the Neanderthal is perhaps the best documented of the other human species. Not only have there been several specimens found over great swathes of Europe and Asia, but mitochondrial DNA has been extracted from their specimens. Mitochondria are the components of a cell whereby chemical energy is converted into the energy that organisms can actually use. This form of DNA is only inherited maternally, but more on DNA later. Neanderthals were very adept with their use and creation of tools. There was an increased diversity not just in design, but also the uses of them. They had developed multi-purpose tools indicating a varied diet. As well as animal prey, they were digging up roots and tubers, and grinding up plant materials, as well as even cooking vegetables. Spears were certainly developed by this point, allowing them to strike larger animals without getting too close. Tool retouchers were also developed to maintain them as well, tools to preserve other tools. As advanced as they were, the technology didn't change much during their existence. They had good long-term memories when it came to being able to replicate other tools, something not seen in modern primates aside from us. But did they have initiative? Around the same point that Neanderthals evolved in Europe and Asia, another species of human was evolving in Africa. Us. Homo sapiens, the modern human. In the same amount of time that you could say Neanderthal technology didn't develop very much, the same could be said of the technology of our own species. This form of human adapted for a hotter environment was a typically taller and more slender being than their Neanderthal cousins. That being said, cultural traits were also shared, like ritual burying of their dead. The two species did eventually meet. The Out of Africa hypothesis is currently the most widely accepted idea regarding our species dispersal. The species model is a tricky one, as taxonomy was invented before knowledge of genetics or evolution. It was long thought that Neanderthals were ancestral to our species, but it appears not. The mitochondrial DNA extracted from Neanderthal remains resembled that of modern Homo sapiens. When our species moved into Europe and Asia and encountered Neanderthals, it would be very apparent that they got on at least reasonably well if they were mixing DNA with each other. Such specimens of Neanderthals with modern mitochondrial DNA have been found as far as the Caucasus, over by the Caspian Sea, so these developments were clearly widespread. But what happened to the Neanderthals? They became extinct around 37,000 years ago. There are several ideas as to what led to their extinction. They were hyper-specialized for the Ice Age environment, and the climate was changing. They could have been in direct competition with Homo sapiens, or breeding with us could have led to total dilution of their genes. With our expansion, we could have brought diseases that mean little to us, but devastation to the Neanderthals. It was likely a combination of these and several other factors that led to their demise, leaving us the only species of human on Earth. As well as Neanderthals, there were other humans contemporaneous to us, like the Denisovans, which we know little about, and Homo floresiensis, a dwarf species of human found on one Indonesian island. Both of these species were formally identified in the 21st century. It seems that every discovery of human fossils and trace fossils totally reshapes our understanding of human evolution. Such is the malleability of paleontology, with recovery of further evidence. But what about us? Homo sapiens, the anatomically modern human, the last human species. Why are we special?
Regarding our anatomy, we're the only ones without a brow ridge. We've got the most bulbous and round of the brain cases, the only ones with a true chin, and also we've got a narrower pelvis. And the narrower pelvis could be key to this.
Human babies are fairly useless. They can't even walk. Our big brains have to keep developing fully outside of the womb. With this, it was imperative for our ancestors to cooperate, nurturing the offspring in the earliest of societies. With our slightly larger brain cases and the lack of direct competition, more complex behaviours and ideas appeared. If another species had been the last, it's difficult to say if they would have done the same.
It seems that the very first anatomically modern humans appeared around 300,000 years ago. But it was many, many thousands of years later that along came abstract thinking like art, transportation technology like the wheel, and the very first instances of agriculture in the Fertile Crescent. The Bronze Age finally extinguished the Stone Age around 3,300 BC in Mesopotamia. And the rest is history.